there's something else you need to know about trading or investing. Whether you're interested in trading in stocks, cryptocurrencies, or forex, you'll often come across these fancy terms like margin or leverage. By the end of this episode, you should have a clear understanding of what is margin trading, how does it work, and all the risk associated with it. Throughout our childhood, we were told to go to school, get a better grade, obtain a degree, and get a high-paying job. With inflation, taxes, and unreliable economy, you soon realize that no matter how much you earn from your job, this method of generating income is not sufficient enough, nor is it sustainable. Enter trading or investing. This is the marketplace where buyers and sellers meet to trade different commodities like cryptocurrencies, stocks, precious metals, and so on. The general rule here is that you buy an asset low and sell it high on a different day or a different time frame at a price higher than the original purchase price and take profit. In this marketplace, we're talking trillions of dollars traded each and every single day. But in order for you to trade in this marketplace, you need to fund your account. This is a down payment that enables you to take part in buying and selling of these assets. So your deposit really determines how much you'll be able to risk on the market. But what if you have an appetite of risking more than what you have? Well, enter the world of margin trading. So what is margin trading? I want you to think of margin trading as a loan. If you ever went to a bank to apply for car finance or a mortgage, well, margin trading is very similar to that, except you're not financing a car or a house. However, you're financing your trading account, and the lender is not your bank. However, it's the broker or an exchange that you're using. When trading on a margin account, a deposit is also required that will act as collateral towards your trading account. So when you open a new trading account, you're presented with two options, like a cash account or a margin account. A cash account simply means when trading on this specific account, you'll be trading with the exact deposited amount on an account. For example, if I wanted to trade $1,000 worth of BTC, I'll have to deposit $1,000 to my preferred broker. Once those funds reflect, I can now execute my trade. But obviously, I don't want to do that right now, so I'm going to cancel this order. But that's what's possible with a cash account, because trading on a margin account is a little bit more complex than the example I just showed you now of a cash account. Brokers will often ask you to sign a trading agreement. Basically, these are just terms and conditions, but sometimes you have to take a quiz to make sure that you have the experience and knowledge required to trade on a margin account. Obviously, this depends from a broker to broker, but brokers want you to be aware of all the fine prints associated with trading on a margin account. But let's look at how it works. When trading on a margin account, you're only required to deposit a small amount of capital to open a new trade. You can then use this capital to borrow more funds from your broker to open even a bigger position. For example, if you wanted to open a new position and buy $10,000 of Tesla stock or Bitcoin, USD to Japanese yen, you don't need to deposit the entire $10,000. You can deposit $3,000, $2,000, or even $1,000, depending on the broker you're using, and the broker will then lend you the rest of the money to open your new trading position. Speaking of brokers, a lot of you have been asking me, what broker am I using? Well, I'm gonna make a separate video detailing exactly what brokers do I use and what brokers do I recommend, and obviously what's to look out for when you're picking a broker. A broker can either make or break your trading experience, so it's very good that you pick the right broker. So make sure you check out the video where I'm going to be showing the brokers that I recommend. If that video is up on a channel, it should be popping right here. But if it's not, make sure you give this video a like, subscribe, turn on post notifications, so you are alerted when I do drop that video. So as mentioned earlier, just like when you take a loan from a bank, margin account is also subjected to interest rate based on the borrowed amount. If you watched our previous video titled "What is a short squeeze?", you'll recall that we actually go in depth in understanding how an interest rate is calculated on the borrowed stock or borrowed amount. If you haven't watched that video, I'm gonna link it in the description of this video. Be sure to check it out. I'm also going to be making a separate video showing you how to trade on a margin account step by step. In that video, we will open account together and deposit funds and actually trade on margin. If you're interested on that video, make sure you subscribe, turn on post notifications, so you are alerted when it comes out. So why would you rather trade on a margin account, not a cash account? You see, a margin account enables us to leverage and maximize our potential profit, which leads us to the next question. What is leverage? Leverage is the ability to control a large amount of funds with using very little of your own. And this enables traders and investors to trade beyond what would have been possible with their cash account. Margin trading became popular with trading stocks and forex, but with the inventions of digital currencies like Bitcoins, we've seen brokers introducing margin trading for cryptocurrencies. In the description of this video, I'm going to leave two links where you can open your margin account for trading cryptocurrencies, irrespective of where you are around the world. It's also worth noting that margin trading is only suitable for more experienced traders. Leverage ratio could be something like 5 to 1, 2 to 1, or 100 to 1. If leverage ratio is a 100 to 1, this will mean that for every $1,000 deposited on this specific account, you can access $100,000 to trade with on your margin account. A used margin is the amount of money that your broker has locked up to keep your current position open. This money cannot be touched until you close your current trading positions or your broker gives it back to you, or when you receive a margin call. A usable margin is the amount of money that is available on your account that you can use to open new positions. This is similar to your banking app where you have available funds and the account balance. While trading on margin can be very lucrative, it's very imperative that you take time to understand the risk associated with it, as it can be very risky when the market goes against you. When the market goes against you, you get what is called a margin call. So what is a margin call? A margin call occurs when an asset or your trading position has decreased in value. When a margin call occurs, the trader must either choose to deposit more funds or sell some assets held on their margin account. Broker may also close your positions and sell your assets to recover any lost funds. So as mentioned earlier, trading on a margin account is a little bit more complex than trading on your cash account. And for that reason, I'm going to do a separate video where we're going to go step by step how to open a margin account, how to deposit funds on a margin account, and how to actually trade on a margin account. If you're interested in a video like that, make sure you give this video a like, subscribe, turn on post notifications so you are alerted when I do drop that video. The next video is an introduction to a crypto trading course, what you guys have been waiting for. So if you want to level up on your crypto trading skills, click on the video coming up next and get started with the future of money. Before you go though, if you have any question regarding this video, leave your comment on the comment section below and don't forget to give this video a like, and I'll see you on the next video. Goodbye for now. Peace.